Before I begin, first I will do a presentation which will take a half hour, in which I will try to cover the basics and explain the do's and the don'ts, etc. If you have any questions, please wait until my presentation is done and then add them in the chat within Sansar or Twitch. Specifically ask you to wait after presentation, because chances are I have answered them during the presentation. Please do not use voice, because I'm afraid your question might not be heard in my video stream, which would be a shame. So please respect that. Type your questions in chat after my presentation. Let's see. I think we're about to start. My stream is also available via Twitch. I will paste the URL also, one moment. There we go. Okay. Shall we start? Yes? All right. Welcome everybody. For the ones who do not know me, I'm Daisy Winthorp, and I will be giving weekly lessons in Marvelous Designer. And my lessons will be focusing on using Marvelous Designer for Sansar in combination with other software like Photoshop, Blender, Substance Painter, and maybe other ones. But I'll try to teach you the basics first. So for those who are new, let's start with Marvelous Designer. What is it? Marvelous Designer is a popular clothing designing software used by innovative fashion companies, world-leading film and gaming studios, and creative hobbyists around the world. With Marvelous Designer, you can create fashion and import them directly into Sansar to wear in your worlds and sell in the Sansar stores. Marvelous Designer is not free, but you can test the program first, and you can get an extended trial if you are a new user of Sansar. The normal trial via their website is 30 days, but via Sansar you can get a 45 days trial. However, the extended trial is only available to new users of Sansar. So if you are unsure if the trial is still available for you, you can check that via the URL account.sansar.com. You will get this screen like shown on the presentation. The monthly fee for Sansar Designer is $50 per month. So Marvelous Designer is not cheap, but do not let that discourage you. You can get a discount up to 50% if you get a description of Sansar. And if you get really good at this, there are more markets where you can monetize your skills. But let's start with the basics first. I'm not going to explain you every little tool within Marvelous Designer. A lot will be covered anyhow during the lesson. But, one moment, let me get a sip of drink. But I do suggest you start at the website of Marvelous Designer first, who offers their own mini tutorials, and there are plenty of other tutorial videos online who do just that. Here you see one of the URLs where you can find the tutorials, marvelousdesigner.com/learn/tutorial. So I'm going to start how to open the default avatar of Sansar. And if you have Marvelous Designer 8 or lower, it is a bit different than with Marvelous Designer 9. In Marvelous Designer 9, the default avatar is built in. Via File, Add, you should normally go into the folder where you can find them. However, if the folder path is changed, you can also find them in your public documents in Marvelous Designer under the avatar folder. And you will have to open either sensor female B or sensor male B. Sensor A is the previous avatar, and once you open it, you click on the AVT extension. Marvelous Designer's avatars can be recognized by the extension AVT. This will open your avatar in the 3D viewer port, and in the 2D viewer port you will see the shadow of the avatar and you are ready to go. But if you do not have Marvelous Designer 9 or you want to work with a custom avatar, you can also load it in on another way. Via File, Import, and then you have several ways to do that, and I usually use FBX. Here I show an example how I import a custom avatar from Quora. In the import FBX menu, you always have to make sure that the scale is in meters, or you use autoscale, which works as well. And in the end, you will have the same result as the default method. You will see the avatar in the 3D viewport and the shadow in the 2D viewport. And again, you are good to go, ready to create some clothing. But before you begin, it is good to know what you can and cannot do in Sensor. Let's start with the limitations. First one, most complained about. Thickness. Thickness is not supported by Sensor. So even if you use thick fabric, it will not carry through in Sensor. But in the coming lessons, I will address that issue and show you ways how to make the design seem thicker. Trims. It's a special tool in Sansa, in Marvelous Designer, and it's also not supported by Sansa. If you use the tools to make trims, it will load up, it will look fine until you start the simulation. At that point, the trim will jump off of your design and sort of explode. Top stitch is also not supported by Sansa. I personally think it is because the stitches are too high poly. And there are also a lot of other hardware options added, like buckles, cords and cord ends, rings and shoulder pads, but all those stuff are not supported by Sansa. They will not get uploaded if you have them in your design. Another limitation that you cannot have is high poly, which is pretty normal in the gaming industry, but if you are new to this, it can get confusing if your designs look super crisp with nice creases and folds in Marvelous Designer, but once uploaded in Sansa, they are all gone or barely there. So what happens is the following. Sansa automatically decimates your design to 15k triangles if your design is above that. But I will explain in further lessons how you can still bake in your details so that it seems high poly while being low. Another limitation is the texture saved in the SAMD file. Even if you save the SAMD file as a 4K, which I do not recommend, it is not as sharp and detailed as it should. You will get more sharpness and details when you load it up as a manual texture, and I will explain that later. But there are also more things that the SAMD file cannot do, like emissive or see-through textures like lace, for example. For those effects, you also need to load up the textures manually. Furthermore, since the fabric can be simulated, you will notice that some designs will be hard to make. Long-hanging sleeves like geisha costumes won't work, nor will things that are extremely close together, like bell bottoms or furry leg warmers, will not work. They will literally stick together when you move with your avatar. But what does work? Okay, let's cover that now. So there's a lot of limitations, but there are still a few left. Things like buttons and buttonholes, zippers, which you can even unzip, offset, in other words, how far you want the design of the skin of your avatar, physical property, how the fabric behaves, elastic, seam taping, to make parts stiffer in certain parts like borders, pins, to keep things in place and the end user can remove them too, steam, which is a tool to shrink or enlarge the fabric in certain spots, pressure, which can be used for things like bomber jackets to give it more volume, another form of thickness. Layers is a method that you can compare with Photoshop layers. It's a way to make sure certain fabric layers stay on top of the other ones. Solidify is a form of memory. It will remember and hold the form of your creases or folds that you want to keep. And last and not least, bond and skive, which is hard to explain in a few words. But what it boils down to is that you can add different fabric behaviors in just a part of your design. But I will cover that in the future lessons. Momentarily. Oh, well, one back. Momentarily, there is a nasty bug though. Sadly, at this moment, we do have a serious bug with buttons and zippers. You see an example what happens with your buttons. As you can see, they look fine before the simulation, but as soon as you simulate them, they turn black. Similar things happen to zippers. The root of the problem lies with Marvelous Design itself, since they are made an error in their new version. People who worked with Marvelous Design 8 and 9 might have noticed that the buttons don't have their own material anymore. And Marvelous Designer needs to change that back. I've contacted them about this, and Sensor did as well. And they told me personally that they would update Marvelous Designer 9 this January. And if they do, I'm sure Sensor will do their part. So it's good to know that if you want to make or wear a design with buttons or zippers, because it happens to all the designs at the moment, newer and older ones. So speaking of good to know, if you want to add buttons to your design, keep in mind they are pretty high poly. You can see that on this picture here. Some buttons are so high poly that you don't even see the wireframe anymore, and they seem solid black. So it's a good practice to fake buttons with tricks like baking high to low mass or avoiding them if possible. Especially when you use a lot of buttons, since Sansa decimates avatars who are heavier than 100 MB. And when that happens, your design will look tarnished and you don't want that. But in the later lessons, I will explain you how you can bake high to low mass to avoid that. Another good thing to know, Sensor uses triangles, not quads. Some creators who came from Second Life might be used to work with quads. But I advise you to avoid that here, because if you load it up as quads, Sansa will still triangulate it. And in the end, when Sansa decimates it, it will cost you details. You can see on this picture, in the first one, you see how the triangles look in Sansa. Beside that example, it shows you in the first picture you can see the triangles. Beside that example, how it looks when you use the function in Marvelous Designer when you quadrangulate it. You might be tempted to use it because it has way less faces, or even use the remesh function, which makes it really crisp and neat. However, if you use the remesh option and bring that as a design into Sansa, it will be re-triangulated and it will look like the last example. And as you can see, it now has more faces than in the beginning. So just leave it in triangles, because that is what Sansa works with. Another good thing to know is that Marvelous Designer has built-in normal maps. For those who do not know what normal maps are, they are usually pinkish, purplish textures which can be used to give your design more depth. It can give you the idea you actually see the fibers or grain of the fabric. Here in the example, I'm showing you the normal map of leather. You add the normal map via the property editor. Let me show you. You add the normal map via the property editor, and when you click on the four dots icon, you will find the normal map in your public documents. In Marvelous Designer, in the materials folder. If you end up in another folder, you can always browse back to this pad. It is always on the user, public, public documents, Marvelous Designer, and then the version of the Marvelous Designer you're working with, materials, fabric, normal maps. Another good thing to know is how to extract your UV maps. You do this by going into the UV editor. You see the triangle in the corner. The rectangle. You go to UV maps. And then you go to the little photo camera with the wireframe behind it. When you click on it, the following menu will pop up, and here you fill in where you want to save the UV map. Choose which size you want the UV map to have, and even change the color of the wireframe if you want to. When you are happy with the settings, just save it, and you will find the UV map in the folder you filled in into the menu. Another good thing to know is a new feature in Marvelous Designer 9, baking textures. Here you can directly save the diffuse, the metalness, the normal and the roughness textures. Again, choose where you want to save it, the size and which textures you want to save. It's pretty much the same workflow as saving the UV map. Now, I'm going to explain you the only right way to create an UV map. If you don't do it right, your texture will look all wrong and will be totally off. That's one of the things that happens to most people, and they don't know, most don't know what the problem is. The first thing you should make sure is to line up nicely. I usually take it to the corner down below. I made a red line where I place it. And you have to make sure to keep enough space between them. After that, you go. Oh, I'm going. Something is going wrong here. One moment. My ice maker, sorry. Okay. I was hanging on my keyboard. Make sure you have enough space between every piece of garment and try to keep it nice and nice and clean before you go to the UV editor. Then you click on the UV editor. In the UV editor, click with your right mouse button and you will get the following menu. The first thing you do is set UV from pattern alignment. And then it will you will see the size change a little bit. And after you've done that, you click again with your right mouse button. And this time you choose Fit UV to Unified. That's the second step. This will bring up another menu where you have to check relative UV coordinate and save the value to 0.01. It's very important that you use those values and click OK. This last step, those value is new to Marvelous Designer 9. So if you used a previous version, you will not have to change this value because there is no option to change this value. When you've done all that, you can finally export your file as SAMD. And that should give you the right UV, then your texture should look right in Marvelous Designer. As you can see, the design is also now nicely within the square. And if you save it as SAMD, another menu will pop up. That's the last step. There you choose Use UV map on UV editor and you can change the texture resolution. Again, I said it before, I would not recommend you using 4K textures. I personally always choose the 1K texture because I always add my textures manually. And this value here only counts for the texture that Marvelous Designer adds to the file. And if you add your own textures, your size will override that. So if you manually add a 2K texture, it will use that 2K and will not resize it to 1K. So if you add your textures manually, it is not needed to make it higher than 1K. It is pointless and it will only take more time to upload it as well. Importing your designs is pretty simple. When you are in the lookbook, you make sure you are in your clothing slot, the clothing hanger icon, and then you click on Browse. Now import first, and then you click on, when the new menu Import Avatar Clothing appears, you click on Browse. And you can add the SAMD file you made. At that point, you can simply push Import. However, if you want to add your textures manually like I do, you click first on Material Settings. And then you will add your textures. Albedo is the diffuse, normal is the normal map, roughness is the roughness map, and metalness is the metal map. When you are done, you click Save Settings, and you will return to the main menu. And when you're done fully satisfied, you can, if you want to, add a picture for the design. I usually do that when I'm happy with my design. I can do that later. But when you can do edit with browser, and then you can add import. As soon as your import is done, you will see a closing hanger appear in your closing slot. And then you can click it, and your avatar will wear it. To simulate it, you go to the menu above, where it says worn items, and you can click on the little play button and when you hover over it will say adjust item. In simulate mode you can make creases the way you want by pulling on it, tugging on it, and when you are done you will simply click done adjusting and it will save the adjustment. So that is basically the base knowledge you need to know for making clothing you want in Sansar. Now, if you are already an advanced creator and use other programs for texturing like Maya or Blender or Substance Painter, you will need to export your design from Marvelous Designer first to work on. Usually you will use OBJ or FBX for that. So for that we go a step back and we go back to Marvelous Designer to the point you just created the SAMD file. On that point you can also make an OBJ file or an FBX file. And you do that with the following settings. Via export you can go to OBJ selected and you make sure your design is selected, of course, and you make sure you choose single object. You can make sure you have to set a texture, and you make sure the scale is in meters. Then you export it. For FBX, the settings are pretty similar. However, before you export it to FBX, it is wise to make sure you delete the avatar first. Because if you don't, your FBX will also contain the avatar. But the settings for FBX looks like this. Again, thin, make sure you have a texture and the right size, and click OK to save. Now you have saved it, and you can import it into the program of your choice and edit the texture of the design. Okay, so far the basic knowledge. Anybody having questions at this point, please type it in chat so I can address them. I use FBX. Purely FBX, omdat when you use OBG, I use Substance Painter. And when you load in an OBG, every part of OBG will get his own material. And that's not the way I designed it. If you are in Marvelous Designer, everything that has his material has his own. Here you can see, let me see if I can add, I see my mouse is not showing, does not show on screen one moment. Let me see if I can change that. Settings. Haha. thought I had it on, but I cannot find it at this moment. But if I show you here an example, and you have here in top, you have fabric. Oh, my mouse is showing, right? You have fabric, and if you have a specific part, I don't want everything that is red, but for instance, in a design, I don't want to have every little thing have its own material in Substance Painter. So I noticed that OBG has the problem with that. So FBX is the thing I use to work with. Any other questions? I don't think so. Okay. Well, let's start then with the basic thing, how to start. Let's open an avatar. That's avatar. I will take a mail. There are a few ways you can start designing. You can start drawing, very simple. And try to make a t-shirt that way. But that can be hard, because if you never designed clothes before, the reality is that some things are not the way you might think they should work. So what I suggest is to start with actually patterns, and you can download quite a few on the internet, and it will give you an idea how things work. So to first start, I will make a rectangle. Oh, I see. One moment, I don't see any. Yes, okay. Yes, okay. I start with a rectangle, and I'm going to add the pattern inside. So I'm going to fabric. And here I can choose a texture. I'm opening. And as you can see now, the texture is multiplying. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to edit texture, click on it. Then I have a little tool here in the middle, in the corner, and I will first enlarge my texture. And I will try to get it bit that it should fit. This is the front, so that should fit the avatar. That looks like it should fit like that. If I'm not sure, I can also click on the fabric, take opacity. And you can also see by the shadow that it should be around that, maybe a little bit smaller. That's maybe too small. Let's start with this. Now I'm going to enlarge the, and I'm holding my shift button now, so that it stays straight. And I'm going to get the whole texture in there. Oh, that's not what I want to do. Why are you doing that? Okay, got it. Get the sleeves. This is the basics of a t-shirt. So how do I get this to be a pattern? Now I'm going to go to internal polygon line. You can draw internal in this piece of fabric. This is a piece of fabric, actually. So now I'm going to make lines in there, and every click I make is straight. But I can add a shift button. First, I'm just going to click, and when you see a pink line, it's in line with the previous dots. Then I'm going to curve it with a curve tool. I can edit it later so that if there's not as it should, I can still change it. That's one. I'm going to do the same for the back. Again, I'm going to put some dots. It's pretty simple. They're all pretty straight. Not that difficult. Then I'm going to take this tool again, that the edit curvation, curvative. Give it a curve here and a curve there. That looks pretty good. And I'm going to do the sleeve exactly the same. Just follow the form of the t-shirt. See, I'm waiting till the line turned pink, so I know it's a straight line. And I'm going to add some curvation, curvative, like this. This. So that's the basics, but now how do I get that to be the pattern? I'm just selecting it, and you can do, if you hold your shift key and double click the red lines normally, one moment, yes, double click and double, did I remove them? Yes, I did. And I do my right mouse button and I say cut. Oh, why? There's some problem somewhere. And I'm going to do it one by one then to figure out where the problem lies. That one was okay. Cut. That one too. Yes. So now I can actually remove this. Delete this, and this is your pattern of the t-shirt, but still it's just a half. Now there are two ways to do this, because people who use Marvelous Designer cannot do what I can do here. I can do, say, a click on it, right mouse button, and I can say, and let me see, oh, no, one moment, I mean click on the side here, and I can say unfold, and unfold symmetrically, editing with sewing. So that's what I'm going to do now. And it will actually unfold this fabric. And I will remove the texture for a moment so that it doesn't look all weird. And I will add a color to make it more noticeable. And the opacity turn up. So everything I do on this side will also go change on the other side, because I took the unfold with sewing and editing. People who use Marvelous Designer 8 cannot do that, but there is another way they can do that as well. It just looks a little bit different for them. They just select the whole pattern and they say symmetric pattern with sewing. Then you get two halves, but you can merge them later. But it's actually the same procedure. Now, let's see which one was. This was the back, right? This was the back. I'm going to align the pattern now to the avatar, but first thing I will do is change my gizmo. There are several gizmos you can use, and I don't like this one. I usually take the local coordinates, and you can also make it bigger if you like it bigger. I do. I both select them by holding my shift button. And then I bring them to the back. But as you look at the back, you see now that this doesn't look as orange as the front. That is because it is actually on the wrong side. You need to turn the fabric. There are a few things to do that. You can actually, like some people might do, is like do it like this. But why should you? Because there is an easier way. You can also right click it and say flip normal. And it does just that. Now I'm going to bring this more to the front. Bring this more to the back. And here is one sleeve. And I'm not going to add the other one because there's a little trick I want to show you if you not know it already. I'm going to leave it here. And I'm going to freeze it for now so that it's not, when I'm going to simulate it, it's not going to fall to the floor. So freeze. And first I'm going to sew those things together. There are a few ways you can do that. I like to keep things nice and orderly, so I'm going to change it here in the 2D port. But there are a few things you can do. You can actually take it here, and you can do it like this. Now, if you don't see the lines here, you can change that here. There are a few options here you will probably get to know when you are doing it yourself. If you do it, you can turn it off and turn it on. But you can see that way if you didn't do it backwards, because you can also do it wrong, and so we'll show you that too. Delete sewing for now. If you do it like this, you will see, if you see that it, this does not line up. So if you simulate it now, it will go all wrong. So what you can do then is either delete it or just click on it and say reverse sewing. You continue with rest like this, and as you see, because we said symmetric, it will follow the other side exactly the same. So it makes it a lot easier for you. Now we have to do this too, because this was a different way as we can do it in Marvel's Designer 8. And then I can click simulate. And there we got the base of a t-shirt. Still need to have the arms, but looks pretty decent for the beginning. Okay. Now, the sleeve. I'm going to unfreeze it. And I'm going to place it a little bit further down, so the simulation will go easier. If you are doing it from far away, it might not drape as easily as it should. And since we got two parts here, it's better that you make a middle point here. For now, first I'm going to get rid of these points. These are useless at the moment, so I say convert to curve point, and then do that with this one too. Convert to curve point, then I click the line and I say split, uniform split. Okay, that's the easiest way to do it. There is also another way, but let's start with that one. Again, I'm going to take the sewing tool and we do it. Here is easier, then you can see right away if things match up. It looks like that. So now this side too, and I'm going to the 2D port for that, because there it's easier to see. And simulate. And there we got a sleeve. Now I want the same to the other side. Now I could make that same copy, etc. But why should we do it the hard way when we can do it on the easy way? We again say symmetric pattern with sewing. And one moment. It's in the body now, but if you just click on it, get the gizmo, pull it out. As you see, it's already sewn to it. You only have, the only thing you have to do is simulate it. That's the basic, and if you're not happy with it, you can help very easily now change things. For instance, if you think they need it needs to be a bit longer, you can choose one side because the other one will follow, since it's edit, the edit is our they respond to each other. But if you make do the back and front, it's very it's wise to select them both and then pull down. And if you hold your shift button now, it will keep the line straight so that it won't go like this. Just keep so like straight. Again, simulate. And that's all to it. Now, I don't like the shape very much, but you can easily adjust it to your liking. When you are done with the shape and you want to get this piece all together, especially for Marvelous 8 users and below, you just click one line and say merge, and then it will merge together. Now you see here, because I have Marvelous Designer 9, that it's still like this one. Actually, there are still two parts who respond. If I edit, it will do the same to the other side. That will not happen in Marvelous Designer 8. So if you use the Marvelous Designer 8, make sure before you merge it that you are happy with it. And if you're not happy, if you are on the point that you thought to yourself, oh God, I just wish I didn't do that, because I'm still have to work on the site. And that point, and when that happens, I'm showing you how what you can do then is, that's because you will have it like this. You can just take an internal polygon line, go from the middle to the other side, double click, and then you say cut. Actually, you say cut and sew. Then you select them both while holding the shift button and go back to symmetric pattern with sewing. And at that point, again, you have to you can change things, and the other side will be completely symmetric, doing exactly the same you want it to do. So that's one way to do it. However, my personal way is drawing. Where's the restroom? My personal favorite way is drawing on the avatar. So I'm going to remove this. There is a very nice tool here with, say, line avatar. With that tool, as you can see, I'm holding the shift button now, and you see a straight line appear on this in the middle of the avatar. And when I click on it while holding my shift button and going to below and double click, I have one line. And I continue this. You have to keep in mind that you have to end the line every time, so you cannot keep drawing. You have to end the line. So, and what you, the next thing, and I make the neckline, but you want to have it curved. So now, instead of shift, I'm using the control button. And when you, every time when I place a dot, you will see an orange dot appear, and that's for the curve line. And And I'm going to end it here for now and then double click with, so without holding this control button. And I'm going to have a straight line here as well. So I'm going to hold my shift button again. And you see the shift button, the straight line appear again. And double click. Also here, I'm going to have a curve line here again. Or no, I'm not. I'm going to hold my shift so I can get a straight line, but then around the avatar. And at the end again, double click. I'm going to make the armpits. Again, so this is going to be a curve line. You always start just by clicking the first dot and the next dot, depending on what you want, either a straight line or a curve. This I want a curve, so I'm holding my control. And every time when I click, then an orange dot will appear. Until when I'm at the end, I'm removing my button finger from the control button, and this way it's completely around the armpits. The next thing I have to do is to make sure that I have the front and the back, because now it's still one piece and it will not render this way. So I'm going to make a cut here, just like in real fabric. And I will make a cut here. Double click. If you make a click too many, you see I'm trying to make a new line, just click delete and it will disappear. Next thing I want to do, I want to keep this line straight, just like in the pattern you saw from me earlier, this line too. So now I'm going here to edit line, click on that line, right mouse button, and then flatten as a straight line. I do the same with the front, click the line, choose flatten as a straight line, and those are selected now and will be flattened as a straight line. So now I'm going to flatten. I click on it, click the pattern, and this one too. Ooh. Somehow this one somewhere went wrong. I will do it again in a short moment, but I want to show you what happens when I now click enter. It will take a few seconds. And as you can see, here you have the pattern I just draw. But somehow, and this happens sometimes, and I'm used to it, so I draw these kinds of things a lot. So what I'm going to do is remove this very quickly. Somehow, somewhere, this line, and there is a point that it doesn't close as it should. So I'm going to quickly do it again. Remove, because I want everything to be the same. I could use the first one now, but there's a reason why I want it to work in one go, and that I can show you what it does. So I'm going to do it quickly again. Again, the curve line. Straight line. Double click. No, doesn't work, because it has to get yellow before it is okay. That's it. Now I can go further, take this, and I keep my shift button. No, I'm going to make this a curve this time. Make the armpits with a curve. Again, holding my control button. Making a split here. And a split on the side. Let's see if it worked now. Hooray, it worked. As you can see, both can turn to yellow now. And when I click now on my enter button, there we got it. Oh, I forgot one thing though, but we can do that on another way. I didn't make them straight, but that's not that that bad for this design. I can do that on another way. So now we got this, and the beauty is, because I did them in one go, they are already sewn together, as you can see. So that would make things a lot easier in some designs. And the only thing I have to do now is symmetric pattern with sewing, or I could have unfold them, but I used to work like this because of Marv Designer 8. A bit closer, I take my sewing line for the middle part, and I do that in the back as well. Simulate it, and there's a part of the shirt how it it fits perfectly on the body because I draw on it on the body. Now you can of course edit it. This I can say delete all curve points so that it becomes straight. I can do it with the back as well. Delete all curve points. Click on the line. Delete all curve points. Can simulate it, see what happens. Can delete the curve points here. Actually, I'm cleaning up like this, and it's until you get a nice start for your design. It's good practice to remove points that are have no use, like this one. You can do it like that, but I want to have a nice curve here. So what you can do then is use this tool. I use this a lot, smooth curve. You pick the point and the beginning and end point. You click the line and then you make it nice and smooth. I do this here as well. I see that this is also not as it should be. What one thing you can do then is you select it first, you say y-axis to make it first straight so that you can see. Then I can say merge. This way only works in Marvelous Designer 9. If you have Marv Designer 8, at this point I would suggest you make a split in the middle so that you know the middle and split here as well, so that it's easier for you to edit, and then you can make it symmetric again. But in my case it's symmetric at this moment. So now I can take again this nice tool. And do it like this. If I'm not satisfied with the curvation of the now you see at this moment it's not acting like a symmetric pattern. So I'm going to change that. Like you should be able to in Marvelous Designer 8. I'm going to split it first. Uniform split, okay. Take a polygon line, cut and sew, and then symmetric pattern with sewing, and I can merge it then in 9. And it still will be symmetrical. So if I change something on this side, it will go there as well, which can come very handy because a lot of patterns are symmetrical. Make this straight. But this way is actually the basics from my first lesson. I think I'm going to leave it at this. Do if anybody has any questions for now? Thank you. I hope I wasn't too scatterbrained. Okay. Anybody any questions? I see some people typing. Joe Williams or Asha. Okay. Thank you. Very interesting. Okay. Expectancy 11 here. Okay. Well, for next week I will try to go further with how you can build things and how you can make special effects, etc. And if you have any suggestions for designs or don't know how to do certain designs, please do send them to me and I will try to address them in my lessons one by one. You're welcome. I hope you enjoyed it and I hope you learned something from it. All right. Happy to hear that because I was really, really nervous. Thank you.